Hey guys, this is our new X299 Designare EX motherboard. We are very excited to be unboxing it for you, so please stay tuned as we take a look at the box, what comes inside, and explore some of the features of this motherboard. And if you haven't yet, please subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. Now, on the front of the box, alongside the motherboard, you can already see some logos, including the Thunderbolt logo, the Intel X299 chipset, support for Intel Core X series CPUs and Intel Optane memory. This is part of our ultra durable line. It's based on the LGA 2066 socket and it features RGB Fusion, Smartphone 5, and it's a VR ready motherboard. On the back of the box, there's a lot of information. Starting from the top, we are offering a new 12-phase server class digital power design with a turbo B-clock chip. For cooling, it comes with Smartphone 5 and fan stop, and it's equipped with 9 thermal sensors and 8 hybrid fan headers. For connectivity, there's the fast and beloved Thunderbolt technology, which gives us up to 40 gigabits per second bandwidth over USB Type-C connectors. We also have a triple NVMe PCIe by 4 M.2 design with thermal guards. It comes with dual Intel GBE LAN and dual band Wi-Fi. For lighting, you can count on RGB Fusion technology with surround lighting using digital LEDs and supports for digital and RGBW LED strips. It packs a lot more features, such as the ALC1220 audio codec and the WIMA capacitors, so you can have the high quality audio experience. It also offers a USB Type-C connector for the front panel and support for crossfire and SLI configurations. That's it for the box, so let's see what comes inside. We have a user's manual, Thunderbolt card utility driver's disk, a motherboard utility and driver's disk, multilingual installation guide, 6 SATA cables, 2 RGB LED strips extension cable, SLI bridge, M.2 to U.2 card, wireless antenna, M.2 screw kit, a G connector, 2 thermistor cables, 2 Velcro cable ties, stickers, and the motherboard. Alright, now let's look at the motherboard. It comes with a black and silver look, and the latest Armor and PCH overlay designs. And the surround lighting on the PCH overlay, audio and IO shield, enabled by the RGB Fusion technology, helps to bring this motherboard to life. And for further customization, you can use external LED strips with headers on top and bottom of the motherboard. This X299 Designare EX motherboard fully supports the new Intel Core X series CPUs with up to 18 cores. And to make sure we use them to their full potential, we have a new 12-phase power design with some heavy-duty heat sinks on top and 2 8-pin power connectors. Most of us will prefer to use liquid cooling solutions on this platform, but it's not a good idea to leave this area without any airflow, so we added a small fan under the IO shield that will help when needed. This fan is connected to one of the 8 hybrid fan headers that you can find across the board. We have 3 on top, 2 on the side, 2 on the bottom, and 1 up here, together with the 9 thermal sensors and the software where you can monitor and customize every detail. This is our cooling technology named Smartphone 5. And memory is where things start to get a little different depending on the CPU we are using. The 8 DIMM slots provide support for quad channel memory if we are using a processor with 6 or more cores. However, if we use a 4-core CPU, we'll be using dual channel and only the slots on this side will be active. This motherboard also adds support for register DIMMs. If we are looking for that technology and its scalability, you can use DDR4 memory modules with frequencies up to 4400 MHz. And as you can see, the memory slots come with a ultra durable memory armor for the durability. To achieve the best sound quality, we are using the famous ALC1220 audio codec with WIMA and other Japanese capacitors, together with the Sound Blaster X 720 audio engine. This motherboard comes with 5 PCIe slots, 2 of them by 16, 1 by 8 and 2 by 4. SLI and crossfire configurations are obviously supported. Now, due to the different number of PCIe lanes available from different CPU models, we recommend you visit our product page to see the full details of each configuration. We also have to look at the storage capabilities of this board, with triple NVMe PCIe by 4 M.2 slots, all covered by thermal guards, 8 SATA 3 ports with support for various RAID modes, Intel Optane memory, as well as Intel VROC. With user convenience in mind, there are a few onboard buttons. As you can see here, there's a power, reset, and OC button, as well as a clear CMOS button. Also includes is a debug LED, GIGABYTE's dual BIOS technology, and a front panel USB Type-C connector with USB 3.1 Gen 2 support. The X299 Designer EX motherboard comes with a metal base plate covering the back side of the board. There are a lot of interesting things on the back panel of this board, especially because of the Thunderbolt 3 connection, but let's start by saying the I/O shield is already in place and that we have two USB 2.0 ports, a PS2, two DisplayPort ins, two Thunderbolt 3 connectors in form of USB 3.1 Type-C, the active cooling fan vent, two Ethernet ports with Intel GB LAN, four USB 3.1 ports where the white one supports QFlash Plus, allowing us to update our BIOS without CPU or memory, the connectors for the WIFI antenna, and the audio jacks. So this was a first look at our X299 Designare EX motherboard. Thank you for watching, don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel, and feel free to ask any questions.